Tonight on NewsWatch, 40 below zero. A powerful winter blast puts parts of the U.S. in a deep freeze.
Plus, the aftermath of abortion. What pro-choice lobbyists don't want women to know.
And taking a bite out of your utility bill. Why going solar is less expensive than ever. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. The Arctic chill across the midsection of the country is heading east. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Parts of the country are preparing for some of the coldest temperatures in years. Sub-zero temperatures hit the Midwest earlier this week, but by the end of the week, the same system will sweep through the Northeast, the Mid-Atlantic, and the South. The storm system has also unleashed ice and snow, closing schools and canceling hundreds of flights. Paul Strand has more in tonight's top story.
Brutal winds, swirling snow, and slippery ice have assaulted the Midwest, bringing bone-chilling record-low temperatures to states like North Dakota, 29 below in Fargo, 37 below in Grand Forks.
Nice day, real nice day, if you're a penguin.
It's the kind of cold where it makes it really hard to just walk one block and you're just sort of miserable.
At least one man's died from exposure, and more of this deadly cold is on the way.
We're going to see a big swath of snow come through, and it's not just the snow.
It's the brutal cold, which can actually kill you.
The danger becomes frostbite and hypothermia, and this can occur very quickly, 2 to 3 minutes, if you're not well-dressed.
Oh, I got a sweatshirt, a long john shirt, or a sweatshirt and a T-shirt.
These Iowa construction workers have mastered the art of cold weather survival.
As long as you stay moving and you dress in layers, I'm warm.
Now the bitter blasts of below freezing temperatures are hitting the East Coast, with more to come.
It's been years since they've hit the 0-degree mark in New York City, and we think that's going to happen on Friday night.
Back in the Midwest, this winter's snow and ice have already become annoyingly commonplace.
We had like 28 times that we plowed and salted snow between December and beginning of January.
Many just take it in stride.
Living in the Midwest, you always know you're going to get snow, and it's just part of it, so you have to deal with it.
As for dealing with the record cold, as one Minnesota man put it, minus 38 doesn't really feel all that much different from minus 24. Paul Strand, CBN News.
A new audio tape supposedly from Osama bin Laden calls on Muslims to launch a holy war to stop Israel's military action in Gaza. This is the first tape from the al-Qaeda leader since last May. Bin Laden also vows to open new fronts against the U.S. and its allies beyond Iraq and Afghanistan. And for more on this latest message, we are joined by CBN News terrorism analyst Eric Stackelback in Washington. Eric, is this a way for bin Laden just to show that he's still relevant?
Lee, right now it's about the only way that he can remain relevant. Al-Qaeda has not carried out a major attack on Western soil since 2005, the London bombings. They haven't carried out an attack on American soil despite countless threats over the past 7.5 years since 9/11. They've essentially lost Iraq. They put so much into their efforts in Iraq, and they've essentially lost Iraq to coalition forces. In Afghanistan, Pakistan, they are getting stronger in some respects, but also several al-Qaeda leaders have been taken out by those predator drones employed by the CIA and by the U.S. military. So al-Qaeda globally is having its troubles. Bin Laden, we haven't seen him on video in years. So he's been relegated to these audio tapes. This is just a stab at trying to be relevant in the global jihad.
Eric, in terms of these terrorism attacks on the Jewish state of Israel, it's been rather quiet, surprisingly, there, with the exception of Hamas's continued rocket barrages going into southern Israel. But given his calls for jihad against Israel, will we see an upswing in attacks on the Jewish state?
Lee, I don't know if you'll see it in Israel proper by al-Qaeda. Now, you might see an upswing in Palestinian suicide bombers in Israel, but right now Israel is on lockdown and so is Gaza. What I think you might see is Israeli Jewish targets around the world start to be targeted, synagogues, embassies. We're already seeing that in Europe right now.
Thanks, Eric.
Thank you, Lee.
Israel faced attacks from a second front again today. Rockets from Lebanon landed in northern Israel, while troops continue to battle Hamas militants in Gaza. As Chris Mitchell reports, Israeli leaders have not decided whether to push for a ceasefire or expand their military campaign.
Israel's Security Cabinet has not met for several days, prompting speculation that Prime Minister Ehud Olmert and his top ministers don't agree on whether to launch a highly intensive third phase of the attack on Hamas. Olmert is said to favor tougher military action, while Defense Minister Ehud Barak and Foreign Minister Zippy Livni believe the goal of deterring Hamas has been accomplished.
The Gaza fighting has cut deeply into Israel's elections. In less than 4 weeks, Israelis will choose the next Knesset and Prime Minister. But because of the war, there's been very little campaigning.
Opposition leader Benjamin Netanyahu is still the favorite in the elections. But although he has his quarrels with the current government, he strongly supports the Gaza operation. Speaking to the foreign press in Jerusalem Tuesday, Netanyahu called for the removal of Hamas from Gaza, and he challenged the reporters.
What would you do if your country was rocketed for a full 8 years by thousands of rockets? Because that's how long these rockets have been coming from Gaza. 8 years. 8 years are two U.S. presidential terms.
Netanyahu says he will continue to support the government if it works to end the Hamas rocket fire and shut down the tunnels for weapon smuggling from Egypt. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Stock prices tumbled once again today, the Dow closing down almost 250 points. Wall Street is facing renewed economic worries, in part caused by a sharp decline in December retail sales. The Commerce Department says retail sales dropped 2.7%. That's more than double the 1.2% decline analysts expected. It was a record sixth straight monthly drop.
President-elect Obama's pick to head the Treasury Department will be facing questions about his taxes during his upcoming confirmation hearings. But today, Obama said he is not concerned. Timothy Geithner failed to pay $34,000 in taxes several years ago when he worked for the International Monetary Fund. Still, Senate Democrats plan to press ahead with Geithner's nomination, but his tax blunder may complicate the process. And Republicans have not agreed to give Geithner a quick confirmation hearing. Congress is poised to take action to fight discrimination against women. Lawmakers have been inspired by the plight of an Alabama woman who spent a decade fighting for fair pay. CBN's Jennifer Wishon explains.
Lily Ledbetter worked as a supervisor for Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company for nearly 20 years. She received an anonymous note one day that revealed men who started working the same job at the same time she did earned as much as 40% more.
It was so degrading to know that I was considered so less of value than my male counterparts for doing the exact same work.
Women's advocates say it's an issue working females fight every day, since on average, women make just 75 cents for every dollar men make. Ledbetter decided to do something about it. She sued. A jury sided with her, but the U.S. Supreme Court ruled she didn't file her case soon enough, overturning the lower court's ruling on a technicality. Now Congress is taking action.
The bill overturns the unfair Ledbetter decision, where five members of the Supreme Court basically told employers everywhere that if you can just get away with cheating an employee, usually a woman, for 6 months and not have them call you on it, you have our permission to continue to cheat them.
The House passed the Lilly Ledbetter Fair Pay Act last week, despite warnings from critics that the bill has unintended consequences.
Especially in this economic climate, we cannot afford to enable endless litigation and potentially staggering record-keeping requirements on employers.
Ledbetter says fair pay goes beyond women. She says it's about families and quality of life.
In today's society, it takes, in most households, two people, especially for their children, to maintain a middle-class livelihood.
Now, the bill's fate lies in the hands of senators who will vote Thursday on whether or not to debate the bill.
If it ultimately passes, the Lilly Ledbetter Act could become the first piece of legislation President-elect Barack Obama signs into law. He even invited Ledbetter to join him on his train ride from Philadelphia to Washington to take the oath of office. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Incoming White House Press Secretary Robert Gibbs says Barack Obama will get rid of the controversial "don't ask, don't tell" policy on gays in the military. The policy went into effect during Bill Clinton's presidency and allowed gays to serve in the military as long as they kept their sexual orientation private. Getting rid of the policy would pave the way for homosexuals to serve openly. Obama may wait, though, until next year before he asks Congress to send him a bill on a new policy. But I spoke by phone to Elaine Donnelly of the Center for Military Readiness today about how this could affect our armed forces.
If the law is repealed, we're going to get a whole new category of misconduct. We're going to have male-male incidents as well as female-female incidents. There is no way that anyone can argue that this new policy would benefit the armed forces in any way. The Barack Obama administration is going to have to realize that a social agenda promised to activists in San Francisco and throughout the campaign, if applied to the military, would have harmful consequences.
You can hear more of my conversation with Elaine Donnelly at CBNNews.com and get David Brody's analysis on Obama's plans to let homosexuals serve openly in the military on his blog, The Brody File.
We have a follow-up on the inauguration lawsuit filed by atheists. The American Center for Law and Justice is asking a federal court to throw out the case demanding prayers and the phrase, "So help me God," be banned at Tuesday's ceremony. In a brief to the court, ACLJ Chief Counsel Jay Sekulow writes, quote, "This is once again a flawed attempt to purge all religious references and observances from American public life. The fact is that this country has a long history of invoking God at inaugural events." The case is scheduled to be in court Thursday. It's been filed by atheist Michael Newdow, his third attempt to stop prayer at inaugurations.
And coming up, the toll abortion takes on a woman and how it can affect mental health.
Over the last several months, we've been talking with everyone who has Medicare about the money-saving health plans from Humana. These are all-in-one plans that combine medical and prescription drug coverage, all with an affordable monthly health plan premium that may surprise you. If you have a separate drug plan with Original Medicare or with a Medicare supplement, you could be getting more benefits and saving money with Humana's Medicare health plans. Could Humana be a better value for your health care dollar? Call 1-800-552-8937. Or go online to humanafreebook.com and get this free booklet that will help you decide if our all-in-one plans are right for you. More than 1 million people have made the call and are enjoying Humana's all-in-one Medicare plans. The facts you need are in the book, and it's totally free. Call 1-800-552-8937 or go to humanafreebook.com.
If you have Medicare, I have three things you'll want to hear. There's an all-in-one Medicare health plan from Humana. It includes Medicare prescription drug coverage, and it can save you money in so many ways. It's all in this book, and it's yours free just for calling. You'll see all the ways the plan saves you money, including prescription drugs. In fact, Humana Medicare Advantage members saved, on average, over $1,400 on their prescription costs last year. And you get all this coverage with a monthly health plan premium that may surprise you. Even if you've looked at Humana before, you need to take another look at this plan. Call 1-800-552-0740. We'll send you the decision guide absolutely free, in a slightly smaller size, of course. Discover the all-in-one Medicare health plan that can cut your costs and cover your prescriptions. Call 1-800-552-0740 or go to humanabigbook.com. The savings are too big to miss.
The U.S. House has voted to expand health care for children. About 4 million more children would receive government-provided health care under a bill passed by the House today. It goes to the Senate Thursday. The plan would be paid for with an increase on cigarette taxes. But Republicans complain the bill provides coverage for children of legal immigrants, even if they are not U.S. citizens.
Pro-life supporters say another new health care bill will provide a bailout for the abortion industry. But Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid says it's about reducing abortions. The Prevention First Act increases contraceptive funding through Planned Parenthood and its Title X programs. Reid says contraceptive use keeps the abortion rate low, but pro-lifers tell CBN News that parental involvement laws work better.
Contraceptive services have already been funded quite extensively, and that hasn't resolved a lot of these problems. So this bill is really something. It's a top priority for Planned Parenthood, some of these other groups. They need more money, and this is the way they're going to get it.
The bill also requires health insurance plans to cover birth control, but pro-lifers say that could pose a problem for religious groups that offer insurance to their employees but oppose contraception.
Women who have abortions are at higher risk of mental health problems because of the abortion. Those are the findings from two separate studies released within the last month. CBN medical reporter Lori Johnson has more.
The two separate studies, one in the Journal of Psychiatric Research, the other in the British Journal of Psychiatry, both stated the same thing. Women who had abortions experienced more emotional problems than women who did not. Issues like depression, anxiety, and substance abuse. This came as no surprise to Dr. Linda Mintel, who counsels women who've had abortions.
Abortion is a loss. It's a loss of a life. And so it only makes sense that even though you may have thought in your mind that this is what you wanted to do, it still feels very out of control for women once they do it. And so that out of control loss feeling results in anxiety.
Women sometimes reach for drugs and alcohol to escape those heavy emotions. In contrast to the studies linking abortion and mental health problems, the American Psychological Association issued this report claiming there is no such link. But some experts dispute those findings.
I have to tell you that I feel like there is a lot of political pressure put on researchers and therapists to not really talk about the downside of abortion because there is such a strong pro-choice lobby in our country.
Mintel says women considering abortion should be warned about the negative feelings they'll experience when it's over. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
One peanut butter company is issuing a recall because the product may be contaminated with salmonella. The Virginia-based Peanut Corporation of America is recalling peanut butter that was produced at its Georgia plant. The company says the product is not sold in retail stores but has been sold to institutions. Three deaths in Virginia and Minnesota have occurred from salmonella, and more than 400 people in 43 states are reportedly ill from the outbreak.
Up next, solar energy. Why it's becoming more affordable.
The doctor said to me, Peggy, you don't understand. Pancreatic cancer is inoperable and incurable. And he says, well, Peggy, you've got 2 months to live. It was like he was telling me, go to the store. There was no compassion. Yeah, it was heartbreaking. My life was an hourglass. I was home laying on the couch, just dying. My sister Pam called the Cancer Treatment Centers of America. When I got there, I knew that I was going to be cared for. I met with a doctor after the tests were done and said, how long do I have? And he looked at me and he said, Peggy, we did a lot of tests on you, and I never saw one thing stamped on the bottom of your foot that said you were going to die in 2 months. You have no expiration date. And I thought, wow.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is unlike any other cancer hospital, full of hope, committed to your fight. We use every weapon, surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, nutrition, spiritual support, and mind-body medicine. We surround you with a real team, working together, all under one roof.
Each time I went back to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, I responded better. My tumors were shrinking, came back in September again, and they still couldn't see anything. I said, you're kidding me. We'll see how it goes. We'll keep testing, but we can't see the tumors anymore.
Please call the number on your screen to speak with an oncology information specialist and receive a life-changing information kit and DVD packed with valuable information. Call now and learn about treatment options you may not even know exist.
It's really unbelievable how one doctor can tell me I have 2 months to live. And then I go to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, and they saved my life. Hope is a mainstay. Hope is everything.
Don't give up. Your fight is our fight. Call Cancer Treatment Centers of America today.
Solar power is becoming a more popular and more affordable way to power homes. USA Today reports rooftop systems that cost about $23,000 last year could drop to as little as $10,000 this year. Prices are falling because of all the increases in supply and new federal tax credits. Well, California currently accounts for nearly 70% of the U.S. solar market.
But it's not just on the sunny West Coast anymore. CBN's Mark Martin found more people using solar power to save money when he traveled to Vermont last year. He has tonight's Focus Report.
Amos Post is the lead installer for the Vermont-based company Grow Solar. He's supervising the installation of solar panels on the roof of this home in Andover, Vermont.
Business has really picked up. We've already doubled the size of our installations right here in Vermont.
Each photovoltaic panel weighs around 45 pounds and produces 190 watts. Now the panels convert sunlight into wattage, which is then thrown into the house to feed anything that needs energy.
The panels themselves put out DC power. Now this inverter takes that DC power and converts it over to AC power, which will now be usable for your house.
The solar electricity system in this home is tied to the utility grid, a give-and-take system where the sun powers items like lights and appliances. If there's little or no sunlight, the utility kicks in. So how much does this cost? Grow Solar estimates that depending on where you live in the United States, after incentives, a 10-panel grid-tied system will run you around $10,000 with a payback of 6 to 8 years. That system powers approximately a third of the average home's electricity.
Excess power that's made during the day, which happens very frequently, goes backwards through the electric meter, making the meter spin backwards, which is very cool to watch. And that power then goes up to the utility where you're given a credit for it, and then at night or in periods of heavy energy use, you pull that power back in. Each one of these is an individual solar panel. Each panel is wired to the next, to the next, to the next.
Jeff Wolf is the CEO of Grow Solar. Part of the company headquarters is powered by these rooftop photovoltaic panels.
To me, it should be the landscape of America.
Jeff and his wife Dory co-founded Grow Solar. Their push to use the clean energy of the sun is a lifestyle, at work and at their Vermont home. You can see the large solar panels in their yard.
I see it as a picture of beauty, but I'm pretty biased.
And on their roof.
I'm generating electricity without polluting the air. I am using less fossil fuel, so thus generating less carbon.
Jeff and Dory's home also uses the sun to heat the water. Here's how the solar hot water system works. Underneath that large panel up there is an eco-friendly mix of antifreeze and water. It's heated by the sun, and then that mix comes into the home to heat the domestic water.
That we can then use in our showers or sinks.
Dory says tapping into the sun is helping them save on their utility bills.
Absolutely. On our electric bill, we're talking a connect charge of $11 a month is our goal. Our fuel bills are helped by the hot water solar.
If you buy solar today, put it on your home, you know what your power cost is for the next 25, 30 years. And that's a great comfort. It also helps to keep people in their homes. One of the forces that's driving people out of their homes is high heating costs, high electric costs. If we can keep those costs stable, that keeps people in their homes.
More and more Americans are buying into solar. Although it still represents less than 1% of the energy mix in the United States, there is growth. According to the Solar Energy Industries Association, grid-tied solar PV grew more than 48% in 2007 compared to the year before. At the end of last year, the U.S. had more than 3,400 megawatts of installed solar power. 1 megawatt of solar energy can power around 250 homes.
Is that all right? You want it like that?
That's fine.
Okay.
Improvements in technology and an increase in manufacturing capacity are lowering the cost of solar, making it more mainstream around the country.
We're bringing the cost of solar down in a lot of different areas. The panel prices are coming down as we buy higher and higher volumes and as higher volumes are manufactured. The power conversion technology is becoming very reliable and less expensive.
Federal tax credits also sweeten the deal. Congress recently approved an 8-year extension on the 30% tax credits for home and business solar installations. In addition, lawmakers eliminated the current $2,000 cap on those credits. The U.S. ranks fourth in the world for installed solar power, behind Germany, Japan, and Spain. Jeff Wolf believes America will rise in the rankings in less than 10 years.
I think the industry is barely started at this point. I see the solar industry being a major employer and a major driver of the U.S. and the world economy moving forward. Solar will become a double digit, greater than 10% energy contributor to the U.S.
When photons of light energy hit that wire, it creates an electric current.
Environmental scientist Amy Seidel of Living Future Foundation in Vermont also sees tremendous potential in solar energy.
Every day, the sun's energy hitting the Earth's surface creates more power than the whole world needs in a year. So the opportunity for us as inventors and people who can innovate around that resource is to come up with technologies that capture it even better than it now does.
Capturing the energy of the sun, and breaking our dependence on foreign oil. Mark Martin, CBN News, Vermont.
The doctor said to me, Peggy, you don't understand. Pancreatic cancer is inoperable and incurable. And he says, well, Peggy, you've got 2 months to live. It was like he was telling me, go to the store. There was no compassion. And that was heartbreaking. My life was an hourglass. I was home laying on the couch, just dying. My sister Pam called the Cancer Treatment Centers of America. When I got there, I knew that I was gonna be cared for. I met with a doctor after the tests were done and said, how long do I have? And he looked at me and he said, Peggy, we did a lot of tests on you, and I never saw one thing stamped on the bottom of your foot that said you were gonna die in 2 months. You have no expiration date. And I thought, wow.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is unlike any other cancer hospital, full of hope, committed to your fight. We use every weapon, surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, nutrition, spiritual support, and mind-body medicine. We surround you with a real team, working together, all under one roof.
Each time I went back to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, I responded better. My tumors were shrinking. Came back in September again, and they still couldn't see anything. I said, you're kidding me. We'll see how it goes. We'll keep testing, but we can't see the tumors anymore.
Please call the number on your screen to speak with an oncology information specialist and receive a life-changing information kit and DVD packed with valuable information. Call now and learn about treatment options you may not even know exist.
It's really unbelievable how one doctor can tell me I have 2 months to live. And then I go to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America and they save my life. Hope is a mainstay. Hope is everything.
Don't give up. Your fight is our fight. Call Cancer Treatment Centers of America today.
Finally tonight, millions will make their way to Washington to watch history being made as Barack Obama is sworn into office.
It's going to be exciting, but others actually plan to influence history through the power of prayer. Gospel recording artist Stephen Hurd will be singing at the People's Inaugural Prayer Breakfast this weekend. While Obama campaigned on change, Hurd says Christians should unite in prayer for real godly change.
The anointing of God would shake Washington so much so that God would strategically, like he only does with his sovereign wisdom, cause his presence and his manifest glory to disturb our president, our new president, his cabinet, his leaders, and infuse their, his wisdom so that they make decisions that will be not just good decisions, but they'll be God decisions.
Amen.
Bold prayer there, isn't it?
Yes, and for more from Stephen Hurd, you can go to our website at cbnnews.com. Well, that's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can email us your comments and questions at newswatch@cbn.com. And we hope you'll join us next time.
Bye-bye.